I am Rajiv Chaturvedi. I am from Jaipur, and I am into this tire industry from like almost 14 years. I worked with Orient for 5 years, then with Asian, and now I am with Qtons right now. The basic process of manufacturing of tires is the selection of raw material is there. Mainly the raw material which is used for making tire is China clay, which is available in Rajasthan in lot, and feldspar, silica, and these ingredients are mixed together in a ball mill and for a particular time period, and then it is been dried up. After drying, that raw material comes into a powder form. This powder form of raw material is mixed together, and we make a dough kind of thing, which that dough is being then pressed with the pressing machine and into different sizes. Then we got a biscuit of any type. That size can be vary as per the pressing machines. It can be 2x2, it can be 1x1, it can be 2x4. Once we get that biscuit, then that biscuit is being processed into clean for firing. The firing process of tile is approximately 40 to 45 minutes, depending upon company to company. Once that biscuit is fired, the first firing is known as the biscuit firing, and then we get a proper one tile without any glaze or anything on that. After biscuit firing, once we get that biscuit is ready, then we do glazing on it. Now glazing is nothing, it is basically a coating of a glass. Glazing, though it plays a very very important role in tiles, because a glaze is a very very costlier material, it decides the quality of tiles. Approximately 30% cost is the firing cost of tile, because firing is done with the gas, and that gas is available only in Gujarat. Now once we get the biscuit, then that biscuit is being coated with the glaze. Glaze is nothing but basically it is a liquid glass. Glass is being fired at a very very high temperature and converted into liquid. Then that liquid is being added a china clay or a different color that has been added into it to get a different kind of colors on the tiles. So it gives a coating, it gives a layer on tile. Once we glaze the tile, then we do a printing. Screen printing was there, then it comes rotor printing was there, in which we get a multicolored thing, and now the technology has been changed. It's now totally a digital printing is there. It has been started around 4 to 5 years back. Even paste your photographs also on time. It is totally computerized, and with digital technology we can use n number of colors also. Then we do the sorting of tiles. Sorting of tiles has been in most of the good companies, they do automatically. The tile has been passed through the sensors, and if it is there is a deviation in size, the tile automatically gets sorted out. There are 2-3 different categories which most of the good companies prefer, like that is a premium quality, there is a standard quality, and third is a commercial quality. The tile has been sorted out according to the quality of tiles, and then it has been packed and ready for the dispatch. India is coming up in a very big way as a tile manufacturer right now, and people are coming up with best of the technologies in India, and they are making tiles in India and exporting it to across the world. The mother industry is the ceramic industry, if you call it. Ceramic industry is one of the oldest industry of the world. We are making potteries is a part of ceramic industry, we are making sanitaries, this is a part of ceramic industry, and tile is again a part of ceramic industry. So tile trend, earlier people were not using it. It started approximately 40-45 years back in India, when the first company, in India is J. Johnson, who has started this thing. Then came the Somany into picture. Somany is again a very old company. And then Orient was there. They were like cousins. Then came Kajaria into picture, which has changed the trend of the tile industry. So like Nitco has there, then Asian has started. Earlier people were using tiles, but architect especially, they were, or even the client, are not fully convinced with the tiles, because they were more convinced with the stone, with the marble, with other things. There is a problem of band which is an inherent characteristic of tile, which nobody can change. Because the raw material what you are getting, that is from the earth only, okay? And you have got no control onto it. So, when you fire it, and even if there is a change of temperature of 2 to 3 degrees centigrade also, then there is a difference in printing will come, difference in sizes will come. So, for any floor tile, it is always been suggested to use a spacer, at least 3 to 4 mm spacer in between, okay, which is to be filled with the matching color of grout on top of it, okay. So that was the thing suggested by all tile companies to their clients also, to avoid the band problem. Things changes around 3 years back when Qton is imported a new technology from Italy, and they have made a flexible tile. Okay, that they call it like I marble. The tile has been so flexible, like you can mold a tile up to 6 to 8 inches. And with this flexibility of tile, that band problem is being avoided. The advantage of tile, if you see it with the stone, like first stone has got some limitations. Marble, it's all come from earth. There is no, you are not aware what you will get. You cannot, if you get a block, you are buying a block, you are not aware what things comes inside. But here, since it is a man-made thing, we can make anything what we want. We can decide any color, we can decide any designs onto it, okay? We can make any kind of replica of any good marble. Now that band problem has been sorted out because of the flexibility of tile. The tile can adjust the space. Classification of tiles, what I think, tiles has been classified into three parts. First is the ceramic tile, second is the porcelain tile, and third is the vitrified tiles, okay? Ceramic tiles are those tiles which has got a water absorption level from 10 to 16% or 17%. Okay, those tiles are known as the ceramic tiles. Earlier only ceramic tiles were available and people used those tiles for their toilets and all. Then porcelain tiles came into picture, which has got a water absorption level somewhere between 3 to 7%. And then around in 2007 or 8, you can say like around 10 years back, vitrified tiles were introduced in India. Vitrified is basically, it is basically a process of in which water absorption level of any product reduces to 1% or lower than that. Okay, that process is known as a vitreous process, and tiles made from that process is known as a vitrified tile. So when the water absorption level reduces to such a level like 1% or 0.5%, then the mechanical strength of the tile increase, okay, and the strength of vitrified tile is almost equivalent to stone. People used to make a soluble salt, we call it as a soluble salt also, or a polished vitrified tiles, simple tiles, okay, in which tiles has been made and then printing is done on that and then polishing is done. There was no coating of glaze on that. That's why it is known as polished vitrified tile. Since there was no glaze on top of it, so that glossiness was not there, one. Secondly, we are not covering it, so the pores will remain open on top of it. Those pores absorbs stains, okay. So that was the major problem of vitrified tiles. Whenever anything falls onto it, so that stains comes over there. To rectify that problem, a new technology came into picture, that is known as a nanotechnology. It is nothing but it is basically a coating has been done on a vitrified tile, on soluble salt tile, okay, that is known as a nano coating. It is basically a kind of a wax. Then the second thing came into picture to make a double charge tile, or a, we call it as a double charge, we call it as a multi charge, okay, in which the tile has been, two layers of tiles are made, okay, and then they are pressed together. Again, it has got no glaze on top of it, but the glossiness is very good, okay, and better quality of printing can be done on that. So that double charge is right now also in like it is doing very good in India, and it comes into many sizes like 600 by 600, 800 by 800, 600 by 1200, and it's a very strong tile. Then the third things came to make a permanent solution is doing a glaze coating on a vitrified tile. That is known as a glaze vitrified tile, GVT. Okay. That GVT has changed the entire scenario in tile industry, because that vitrification process is already done and a glaze coating is done on top of it. So with that glaze we can do any kind of printing also. So that GVT has changed the entire process, and many companies are making now that GVT tiles in India. Then another thing came like PGVT, that is after making that glaze tile, glaze vitrified tile, we do some polishing on it. Okay, so these are the basic categories what I feel available in tiles in India. As far as usage is concerned, it is divided into two parts. It is into a wall tile and into a floor tile. Earlier people used ceramic tile on walls, especially for their toilets. Now the trend has been changed. People are using only GVT or only double charge on their floor also and wall also. Okay, so this is the right now the usage of tiles. Wall tile comes into like different sizes. Earlier the sizes, initially this 4x4 size was there, 4 inches by 4 inches, then 4 inches by 8 inches, like it was a very common size which is still in use in the government departments. Then came 12x18, 12 inches by 18, like jisko hum 12-18 bolte hain. Uske baad then come 2 feet by 1 feet tile size, then 1 feet by 3 feet size came, then many company has introduced different sizes, like 16 inches by 32 inches ka size ka jaane launch kiya. Like we have come up with a size of around 1.5 feet by 3 feet, which is a very popular right now, 8 feet by 3 feet ka size. So these are the different sizes which normally use in wall tiles in ceramics. Some people makes in vitrified also. And in floor tiles, the smallest size earlier was 1 feet by 1 feet, then came 16 inches by 16 inches, then Netco introduced 18 inches by 18 inches. Then 2 by 2 was very much popular, which is still a very, very popular size, used vastly in across India. Then came 800 by 800 size, that again people are making in ceramic, in vitrified, in multi-charge and in GVT also. And 2x4, 2 feet by 4 feet. Now the most popular size right now currently in India is 2 feet by 4 feet size, which is vastly used in wall as well as in floor also. Right now the biggest size which is available in India is 4 feet by 10 feet in tile, that is in 6 mm thickness. The most popular size which is right now in is 2 feet by 4 feet. It comes into the thickness, normally earlier it was in 14 mm, then it was in 12 mm. The most common thickness people use is 10 mm thickness for that, for 2x2 tiles, for 2x4 tiles and for 800x800. 10 mm thickness is the general thickness which normally all the companies make in general. Earlier people were having this presumption like if the tile is thick then it is strength, then strength wise it is got more durability, like, but it is not correct. It depends upon the firing, it depends upon the vitrification process, okay, it depends upon the mechanical strength of the tile. Even the tile which is 6 mm thick is got more strength as compared to the tile of 10 mm thickness. Okay, so these are the basic things, basic different sizes which are available and the basic thickness which is available for wall and floor tiles. Nowadays people are using tiles for exterior also, and for exterior it is a very, very suitable product. Earlier people use only paint or stone for that. Now tiles have come in a stony finish. They have got a punch which is which you feel like a stone only. Okay, punch is something which gives the shapes of tile, and we use a rustic kind of glaze on that. Okay, those tiles are known as group 5 tiles, okay, which is very, very strong tiles and which has got no impact of weather onto it. So those tiles are very suitable for exteriors. People can use it. It comes into different sizes from 2 feet by 1 feet, even in 1 by 1 size it comes. Earlier people used to have it. In balconies, people prefer their style. 1 feet by 1 feet ka or 2 feet by 2 feet. Depending upon the size of balcony, you can use it. It is also suggested to use the tiles on rooftop also, because it gives very elegant look, fun, like one thing which is, it's easy to clean, easy to maintain, and there is no, the water flows very easily, like there is no stoppage of water and all. Earlier, agar aapki leveling theek nahi the to paani chhat pe badhega, seam aayegi, ye sari issues rehte the. But if you use tiles on your roof also, then it looks very elegant. Most of the commercial building prefer laying of tiles on their rooftop, and they make rooftop restaurants also nowadays. So tiles is one thing which is used for your room flooring in all your areas, in down dining, bedrooms, okay, and in toilets, in kitchen, in your balconies, in your parking areas also. For parking areas, many companies are making full body tile, okay, which has got a bearing capacity of around 30 tons, a truckload bearing capacity is there. So, and it is a very, very suitable product for parking areas. The different kinds of finish which comes on tiles are like 3-4 different finishes are there. One is the glossy finish, second is the matte finish, third is the rustic finish, which are there. Glossy finish is suggested for flooring also, but it's a little slippery. So, especially if there is a wet area, it should be avoided. Matte finish is suggested for the tall toilet floors. If you are using making floor of any toilet, or wherever like you see like some water will be there or a person can sleep, they always use matte finish product. Don't use glossy tiles for toilet flooring. And rustic finish tiles, which are rustic finish products, are generally for the outer areas where a direct interaction with direct contact of atmosphere is there, like sunlight is there. And so rustic finish are products are normally a group 5 product, you can say, like they are very strong. Exterior tiles are all rustic tiles, especially for balconies. If you are using rustic products, are there. And one more finish comes, that is a satin matte finish or a pearl finish product, which is a very, very smooth finish. We use a very smooth kind of base for that. It is again suggested for wall. It looks good on floor also, but it has seen like sometimes you will get a scratch problem on that. So pearl finish product or a satin matte finish is also available. So these are the different kinds of finishes which are available in the tiles on wall and floor both, okay, and for all different kinds. And finishes is comes with the kind of glaze we are using. What I feel personally, wood has got a certain life, maybe for 5 years, 7 years, okay, then you will get a problem of termite, or you will get a problem of water wearing out, all that thing. So now the tiles are coming up in different sizes, in 2x2, in 2x4, in 800x800, all these different sizes, people are coming up with the tiles with a wooden textured finish. One best advantage of tile is when you lay it, like if you are making a new floor, you can lay it with the normal mixture of cement and sand, okay, in a proper 3:1 combination, and then lay it properly. Normally, in most of the areas, in most of the cases, the normal mason laid the tile with this combination of cement and sand, okay, and then they make a slurry, a liquid on top of it, and then press the tile. The best way to lay a tile is, first you lay the tile, you open the box, dip it into water, and then check it properly after laying on an empty floor, on a plain floor, okay, is there any band or any problem or any shed variation is there, because no company will entertain any claim for any defect once the tiles are laid. Okay, so this is one thing which I would always suggest to all the masons. Whenever they lay the tile, they first check it up properly before laying, if whether there is any issue or not. If there is an issue of any like shade variation, because shade variation is one thing which is an inherent characteristic, again it's made from sand and all. So if there is a little variation of temperature, like 3 to 5 degree temperature difference is there, then there are chances of getting a shade variation, one. Secondly, when we make a tile, in one lot we made approximately 3000 square meter of tile, like you can say 30,000 square feet tiles comes in one single lot, okay. Now when we made another lot, so there is always a difference of shades in one lot to second lot. Okay, this is not in control of anyone. You are laying big sizes. Now the big sizes are very much in, and when you lay the big sizes, then it should be laid with the proper adhesives, because the catching power of adhesives is much better than the cement and all. Okay, so it is always suggested to lay the tiles whenever it is a bigger size. Okay, because in smaller size normally the costing part is not suggested. When you are doing like 2 feet by 4 feet or 4 feet by 8 feet size tiles, then you should use good quality adhesives for laying of tile. Okay, second, one of the very important factor of tile is it can, if you are using an adhesive, like, then you can even place the tile on top of any already laid material, like, and when you are using tiles for exteriors especially, then it is always suggested to use adhesives. Molding tiles is normally Mason avoids, because it is a little technical thing. Secondly, like, since the color of tiles is different and the body color is different, so people generally won't go for molding, okay, because you will get two shades. Molding is possible only when you are having a tile of it's a full body tile, okay. When it's a full body tile, then you can mold it, okay. And if it is a flexible tile, then it is much more easier. Earlier, people used to make, when they were making ceramic tiles, especially in wall tiles, people used to have a different kind of motifs, okay, they make. So, as I have told you about earlier, the manufacturing process in which we make the biscuit, then do glazing, then do firing, okay, printing and all that, okay, and final material has been made. So to make it more decorative, people started doing a third firing. Third firing is nothing like people do another printing on a processed product, you can say, okay. That third fire, they use a liquid metal, which they call it Vitrosa. Okay, Vitrosa is the actual technical name for that. Vitrosa is used on that, a different decorative designing is being done, and then it is again fired. Okay, so third fire product is a very costlier product, very costly, and normally all the company sells it by pieces only. Marble is a natural product and it has got a cracks when you laid it, the marble, okay, after some time you will find some cracks has come up, okay, in any good quality, so you have to fill it up with certain resins, again you go for the polishing and all that. So to avoid that thing, tile is a better product. Tile mein there won't be any cracks, there won't be any issues, because it's already fired at 1000 degree temperature or 1100 degree temperature. Cleaning and maintenance, a very important question. Most of the people are not aware of how to clean the tile or how to maintain the tile. One thing I would like to say to everyone, when you use the tile, because tiles are laid during the construction time only, okay, first of all it is suggested always to lay the tiles once all the false ceiling has been done, okay. Once you finish up with all these things, then you lay the tile, okay. Otherwise, because at the time of construction, lot many things are coming up and going up, okay, there are, so chances of getting scratches, stains are very much possible. So it is, first of all, it is suggested to lay the tile in the last. If it is not possible, you have laid it, then it should be covered properly. It should be covered properly with a proper good plastic covering, or good, some people put some POP also on top of it. So it is always suggested to put that thing. Secondly, once everything has been done, tile has been laid and a house had been made, then it should be cleaned properly every day. Suppose if you are using a white Satwario tile, okay, then it should be like a proper white shed, it should be maintained in that way only. If you are having a good branded white shirt, it should be properly dry cleaned, then only you can use it in a proper way, okay. So same way is the tile also, like, it should be cleaned properly every day, okay. There should not be any scratch, there should not be any stains. If something has fallen on that, it should be cleaned properly. As the size goes up, the price increases. Okay, the bigger the size, the bigger, more will the price. Normally, rustic finish metal products are expensive as compared to glossy. So, metallic finish products are more expensive. Again, this thing is because of glaze. You can buy a glaze from 300 rupees a liter to 15,000 rupees a liter. Okay, there's a big difference. So that affects the cost, the kind of glaze you are using. And with the glaze only you will get the finish. Normally the price of ceramic tiles are little cheaper, then porcelain is a little expensive, and then vitrified. Okay, this is the normal thing. But nowadays things have changed. Soluble salt is one of the cheapest product available in the market because of abundant availability. In India it is a very much unorganized segment, so that's why the price are, there is a big difference in price. But if you see what I feel like, the soluble salt should be the lowest, and then porcelain, and then CVT. It should be in that way, and then the, as per the sizes. India is now the biggest exporter of wall tiles in the world. Morbi in Gujarat is being recognized as a hub for worldwide, hub across the world, okay, for making wall tiles. Okay, wall tiles, they are exporting across the world. In floor right now China is number one, but since construction is one thing which is ongoing process which you will find everywhere, and tiles is the one product which is the most suitable product for any construction industry to for covering their surfaces like wall and floor. When we make the polished vitrified tile, like the vitrified tile, first it's made in a formation of polished vitrified tile, okay? Like a normal vitrified tile made, and then a polishing is done on top of it, okay? But we were facing a problem of some holes coming up on top of it, okay, on the surface. So when anything drops onto it, on that surface, it absorbs stains. So that was the most difficult problem of a vitrified tile, which nobody finds any solution. For that, a new technology came into picture, that is known as a nanotechnology. It is nothing but basically a coating of wax is being done on top of the tile. So when that coating is done, all the pores, all those holes were covered it up, okay, and there won't absorb any stain or anything. So this coating is known as a nano coating, okay, which is done on top of soluble vitrified tile, soluble salts, okay, we call it soluble salt also. So but it lasts only for maybe for 6 months or a year, so it won't work out for a longer time. So for that, on vitrified tiles, glazing has been done, okay, and then we make GVT, that is a glazed vitrified tile. So glazing, GVT is the most popular product right now, which is in market. It's available with all the companies, and is one of the most suitable products.